a project composed by four sites, four pillars, and there are three sites already designed. The investment volume of ILAS project is for now exceeding 850 million euros by LAMELIS. It's an European Regional Development Fund. And ILAI must be operational in 2018 with a free pillar. In 2018, the free pillar, the free site, it's in Romania, Czech Republic, and Tibet, will be unified under one single umbrella of an European Research Infrastructure Consortium named ELI-ERIC. And ELI has a base in 2007 until 2010, a 3-year preparatory phase. This phase leads to write a white book. You can download this on the net if you want. It was written by 100 scientific authors from 13 countries with the leadership of ELI initiator, Jean-Paul. And ELI is coordinated by the ELI Librarian Center International Association, a non-profit organization. So to resume the ELI project, it's starting in 2006 with this S3, and after 2007 into 2010 the preparatory pass, with this to the parallel implementation of the three sites, ELI, LAMELIS, LPS, and CGM, and ELI nuclear physics. And in 2018, ELI all these three implementation will be will lead to ERA library. So I will speak about the different facilities. So in 2011, it's in the Czech Republic concerning ELI facility. Then in 2012 and early 2014, the facility will be in Sydney. The first one, Tony Bretzanin in 2011, ELI LAMELIS facility will focus on short pulse secondary sources of radiation and particles with application in new molecular, biomedical and material science, physics and plants, plasmas, particles, matter and laboratory astrophysics. In 2012, it will be the turn of ELAR nuclear physics, which will focus on laser mass nuclear physics with two machines with a very high intensity laser and very intense brion gallium. And the third one is in 2014 in Seged, highly at the second light pulse source facility, which will focus on extremely fast dynamics by taking a snapshot in the attosecond scale, 10 to 8 minus 18 seconds of the electron dynamics in atom, molecule, plasma, and solids. And there will be light source within an extremely broad frequency range in the form of ultra short pulses with high rejection rate. So, ILAMELIS will concern high intensity laser. And this is the fourth one with but the site, the fourth pillar is not decided yet. speak about the first one, fast contrast X-ray imaging. So, since the discovery of Rengen in 1985, he has discovered the X-ray imaging, and this enables to improve the diagnostic of large number of disease. And I can say that this conventional X-ray imaging is working by contrast through differences in absorption. And this X-ray imaging has excellent results when highly absorbing structure. But the main problem of this conventional X-ray imaging is concerning vascular chemotherapy, because the X-ray absorption contrast is relatively poor. And this don't fit into hospital. If closed hospital based X-ray system, it's impossible. If we want to diagnose this mammography measurement. So, we can do impressive result of fast contrast imaging with variant higher energy X-ray beam, whereas the dose is reduced by a factor of 50, the resolution is improved by a factor of 200, and this was demonstrated in a self-control test. So this higher energy X-ray beam enable to detect breast tumor as much earlier stage, I mean 1 millimeter instead of 1 centimeter, by the conventional X-ray imaging. And this is important also for the diagnostic of cartilage heart disease. So, I believe is intervening now by a German IO partner, which topic is clinical oriented approach towards infection and imaging of breast and cartilage tissue. In order to understand the usage in clinic most better. But the problem is that highly variant X-ray sources from freeze regeneration synchrotron doesn't fit into hospital. The same problem as the precedent slide. So, what is ELI contribution is to do compatible top design which can fit into hospital, and this will allow developing such stable top tabletop X-ray system, and by this way ID facility will do an important large scale impact on public healthcare. Thank you for listening.
I was wondering about the time scale of everything. So when do you think something like one of the benefits, for example, an X-ray could be in the hospital?
After 2018, it's in shock. And I don't know how long does it will take from a researcher to do this, maybe 10 years.
So we're talking about very far in the future.